Hello friends, welcome to the channel once again. In this video, we will discuss the solutions of assignment 10 of non-conventional energy resources. The last date of submission of assignment 10 is 10th of April 2019. So without taking much time, we are moving towards the first question. Batteries that have the same voltage use the same reactants internally. It is false. Now let's see the proof. In this picture, you can see that the batteries are of 1.2 volt and 1.2 volt, the first and third battery, and the material is different, that is nickel cadmium and nickel AmH. So we can say the answer is false. Now the second question is, batteries help in moderating the difference between demand and supply across the day by storing and releasing energy as required. It is true. You can see the proof here. It is clearly written that so an energy storage device like a battery makes a huge difference because it helps you manage the supply variation with demand variation. So the answer is true. Now the third question is, primary batteries can be recharged several hundred times typically. It is absolutely false. You can see clearly it is written over here that primary cells are single use batteries. We cannot recharge them. So the answer is false. Now the fourth question is, electrolytes must have good electronic conductivity in order to complete the circuit and enable the battery to function. It is absolutely false. For the proof, in this picture you can see it is clearly written in the on the right side that the electrolyte should have good ionic conductivity and poor electronic conductivity. So our answer is false. Now moving towards the fifth question, the electrode reactions that occur during discharge are reversed during recharging in a secondary battery. So the answer is true. In the proof, it is clearly written over here that these are cells where if you reverse the direction of current, you will have the opposite reactions happening, or at the all the reactions will happen in opposite direction and you will get back the original reactants. Hence our answer is true. Now the sixth question is, in the standard electrochemical series, the potential corresponding to hydrogen electrode is set to 0 volt arbitrarily. It is true. You can see from the proof in this picture, in the middle of the picture there is written SHE, that is standard hydrogen electrode, and the voltage of that is 0. So the answer is true. Now taking the seventh question, lithium metal was used as the anode in early version of rechargeable lithium based batteries. It is true. You can see from the proof in this picture that on the one side there is cathode and on the other side there is anode, and in the place of anode lithium is used. So our answer is true. Now taking the eighth question, when batteries of different capacities and sizes are each discharge from their fully charged stage using C/5 rate, they take same amount of time to discharge. It is absolutely true. You can see the proof here. There is whole the formulas are given, and the value of C rate which I have used is 0.2, which is equivalent to C/5, that is C/5. In this picture I have taken the voltage equal to 20 and the capacity equal to 4, but the time of charge or discharge is 5 hours. Now I am taking the second picture. Here I have taken the voltage equal to 5 and capacity of one battery equal to 4, and C rate is same, that is 0.2, and again the time of charge or discharge it is showing is 5. So time is remaining constant, it is not changing. So our answer is true. Now moving towards the ninth question, charging at 6C rate means a fully discharged battery will be charged in dash minutes. Here the answer is 10 minutes. You can verify it from the following picture. On this picture of C rate, we can see that 1C rate equal to discharge in 1 hour, 2C rate that is 1/2 hour, and 5C rate that is 1/5 equal to 12 minutes. So similarly 6C rate equal to 1/6 hour, and 1/6 hour how many minutes? 10 minutes. So our answer is 10 minutes. Now moving towards the 10th question. If a cell has an open circuit voltage of 1.5 volt and 6 of these are connected in parallel, the open circuit voltage of battery is? Here our answer is the same, that is 1.5 volt, because you can see from this picture, if the cells of a battery are connected in parallel, the battery voltage will be the same as the cell voltage. So our answer is the same, that is 1.5 volt. So this was all regarding the assignment 10 of the non-conventional energy resources which is being run under the NPTEL, and it is always better to submit the assignment as soon as possible. Now you have all the answers, you can submit it easily. Thank you for giving your precious time. See you in the next video, that is in assignment 11 solutions. Take care.